Proudly the first, but hopefully not the last. That's the motto of Captain Nelson, a history-making member of the United States Air Force Thunderbirds. Captain Remoshay Nelson is a proud Georgian, Howard University alumna, and the first black woman to be a United States Air Force Thunderbird. As a young girl, she had no idea that she would one day inspire thousands.
I grew up in Douglasville, Georgia, which is west of Atlanta, come from very humble beginnings. And I just was very adventurous as a young girl. I had no idea what I wanted to be when I grew up, my mom and my biological father separated very early. And then when I was about 10 years old, my mom met my stepdad. And he was so different than anyone else in my family. And he had been in the Navy and traveled the world. He used to tell me all these amazing stories about just life and adventure and all of his cool, like, military stories.
Along with those stories, she always found herself trying to get up and away to the clouds.
There was a tree that used to be outside of my apartment complex. And so whenever I would get in trouble or whatever, I just like would want to get away and get some like peace and to my 10-year-old self, right? I would climb up this tree and just sit there. That was really the place that kind of cultivated these ideas, and currently kind of like where I started to manifest, like that I would be somewhere else, that I would be flying high, that I would be, you know, able to travel and see the world, go to 43 countries, right? So that's kind of where it all started. That coupled with those stories that my dad would tell me about him in the military.
When it was time to go to college, she knew she wanted to attend an HBCU that offered an ROTC program. She chose Howard University, soared in ROTC, and majored in speech communications.
I actually worked with soldiers who had experienced traumatic brain injury while they were serving overseas. And so before even me being in the military, understand what it's like to leave your family and not know that you may not come back home. And so when they come home, you know, they may have experienced an injury, they cannot communicate. And so being able to help that individual say, I love you again, to their wife, to their child, to their loved one, is something that I was really honored to be a part of.
9 years ago, when Nelson joined the Air Force, she learned the history of the Thunderbird squadron she would eventually join.
So the Thunderbirds is the Air Force's official aerial demonstration squadron. So we were established basically during the same time as the Korean War. And what we were looking to do is just to showcase the advances that the Air Force was making when it came to fighter jets and to demonstrate its capabilities. And so the Thunderbirds, our mission is to recruit, retain, and inspire. So we travel all around the United States doing about 60 demonstrations a year, going to 30 different locations, putting on aerial demonstrations. And we are just showing and representing what the Air Force is all about.
When a spot opened up on the highly selective team, she wasn't sure if she'd make the cut.
I doubted myself at first. I said, I don't know if I'm good enough to be on the team. I wasn't quite sure if they would accept someone like me. I had not seen a lot of people who had looked like me on the team. And so I was a bit nervous. I didn't know the statistics or anything like that. I just knew at the time, like what I had seen was not something that looked like me. And so it was a bit intimidating at first, but everyone was super encouraging. And then I went through the very tough interview and selection process and was able to be selected.
Captain Nelson puts her communication skills to use, serving as the team's public affairs officer.
I have the honor of not only being a Thunderbird, but really just training and prepping my pilots for all of our engagements, whether it's interacting with the media, whether it's speaking to a public, when it comes to any of our community outreach, going into schools, helping them really just tell their story and helping the team as a whole tell the Air Force story.
Her proudest moment as a Thunderbird has been giving hope to young kids and healthcare workers during the coronavirus pandemic.
We came up with an idea of working with the local Vegas community to fly over the hospitals to thank all of the healthcare workers who were on the front lines. And so not only to do that, but to give the kids who are out of school, who haven't been able to see their friends, to look out the window and just see a bit of hope and inspiration. That we were able to go on the road and just travel to major cities and fly over hospitals and give the public, the American public, something to look forward to, a bit of entertainment, a bit of normalcy, and kind of be like this beacon of hope and light during a very, very tough time in our country.
Captain Nelson hopes to show young girls that they can fly as high as their minds can imagine.
I just happened to be the first African-American officer on this team, which is a very unique position for me overall, but also I think it's an opportunity to really just show young girls who look like me what they could actually become. And so my hope is that while I have been labeled a first, I won't be the last. Because I want to show young girls what the possibilities are out there, whether it's a leadership role, whether it's serving in the military, anything they want to do, they can become exactly that as long as they work hard and put their mind to it.